I'm the director of a company named Leon Deco Limited. Beatrice Cherono was at pains to explain to the National Assembly's Investment Committee of how she prayed and God directed her to KEMSA, where she acquired a 42 million shillings tender to supply PPEs without any help from any powerful person in or outside KEMSA. The committee continues to unearth the rot in KEMSA on the COVID-19 tenders, with many of the witnesses appearing before it turning comical, as Elizabeth Mutuku now reports.
Appearing before the National Assembly's Public Investment Committee, the director Leon Deco Limited, Eunice Cherono, told the committee that God directed her to KEMSA through prayers.
I really relied on prayer. I prayed about it, and I can tell you without fear that actually it is God who directed me there. I prayed for it, and I can tell you my prayers were answered.
There is vaccines coming into Kenya. Why haven't you prayed so that you get vaccines contracts from cancer? Now that they are coming, and you are a nurse, and you know that vaccines must be used?
To be sincere, I've been thinking about it.
Sorry?
To be sincere, I've been thinking about it.
Okay.
After tough interrogations, the committee established that a commitment letter for Leon Deco Limited was backdated after it was received in May, but it was backdated to April.
The commitment letter is dated 30th April, and the letter of intent that you did is 6th of May.
Maybe, Chair, in our calendar, she doesn't know which month comes earlier than the other. Could be. You, first of all, you need to clarify from her if she knows which month comes earlier.
And now here we are seeing the letter of commitment comes before the letter of intent.
Can you tell us the truth that you are just used, your business name was just used by influential people to do the business? Just tell us the truth.
Cherono admitting that her company partnered with Mason Limited, which funded the 42 million tender to a tune of 30 million.
And design in a joint venture with Mason Austin Limited. Who is Mason
Austin
Limited?
Actually, this is a company I approached when I was looking for funds to buy the masks.
Who owns this company?
Chair, there's something very interesting here.
Eunice.
Yes.
How did you go to ask for funds and you had not been given the intent letter?
The
commitment letter that you should supply? Or you are an angel? You said that you are a very prayerful person.
Actually, I'll tell you, even the lady that assisted me, I didn't know her.
Appearing before the committee as well was a company named Duke Agencies, which was awarded a 182 million shillings tender to supply COVID-19 related items. The director, Elizabeth Rett, was hard pressed to explain how she was awarded the tender to supply 20,000 PPEs despite her request to supply 10,000 PPEs.
We have gone for a 20, we left the 10 because now the manufacturers. It was only one manufacturer the first time who got the material. Now,
I'm actually just asking on behalf I'm just trying to add this up. You know, you walked into KEMSA, you had 10,000 pieces. KEMSA decided not to give you a letter. But when you walked in to request for 20,000 pieces, basically from 90 million, where they did not respond, they responded to the one for 180 million. That is what it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
However, the sittings were disrupted after a section of members accusing their colleagues of colluding with witness to hide the truth.
Interest, it is because of the way they are exchanging their gestures, their facial gestures.
Right,
this
tells
that there is something
that they know.
There's no way you can see people doing like this and then you fail to understand what is happening.
She's sitting on this side. How is she watching us? Are you seeing through us?
Honorable Babu and Wamaua, you will switch off your microphone.
This side and I can see
switch
her.
Off your so microphones like now.
That is why I asked.
Switch
that
off
question.
Your microphones.
Chairman, I think education
Babu, switch
important.
Off your microphone.
Former EACC boss Halaki Wako is also expected to appear before the committee this week to shed light on the scandal after he was adversely mentioned in one of the companies that were grilled by the committee. Elizabeth Mutuku, TV 47 Nairobi.